हैप्पीनेस इज नॉट समथिंग रेडीमेड, इट कम्स फ्रॉम योर ओन एक्शंस. वेलकम बैक टू आवर चैनल. दिस लेक्चर इज ऑन एन इम्पॉर्टेंट ट्यूमर दैट इज लिम्फेंजियोमा. सो वी विल बी स्टडिंग दिस ट्यूमर अंडर द फॉलोइंग सब हेडिंग्स: इंट्रोडक्शन, क्लिनिकल फीचर्स, ओरल मैनिफेस्टेशन, हिस्टोलॉजिक फीचर्स एंड ट्रीटमेंट. सो कमिंग टू द इंट्रोडक्शन, lymphangioma is a benign hematomatous hyperplasia of the lymphatic vessels. 3/4 of the cases occur in the head and neck region. Classification was given by Watson and McCarthy, and lymphangioma is divided into 5 groups. First is the simple lymphangioma. Second is the cavernous lymphangioma. Then comes the cellular or hypoplastic lymphangioma. Then the diffuse systemic lymphangioma. And finally the cystic lymphangioma, which is also called as the hygroma. The clinical features: most of the cases occur in less than 10 years of age, and there is equal gender distribution. The site of occurrence is mostly the lateral part of the neck. When large cystic spaces are found in the lesion, it is called as hygroma. Now, the oral manifestation: the tongue is the most common intraoral site which is affected by lymphangioma. Superficial lesions of the tongue are papillary lesions, and they are very similar to the surrounding mucosa, while the deeper lesions are diffuse nodules having characteristic texture and color. The tongue lesions mostly involve the anterior dorsum of the tongue, and the tongue appears irregularly nodular and grey or pink in color. So here you can see lymphangioma affecting the tongue, the characteristic features. Now there is sometimes lip involvement, and lip involvement of by lymphangioma is called as macroglossia. Cystic hygroma is a condition in which is large, deep, diffuse swelling in the neck. So here you can see macrocelia or lymphangioma of the lip. Then there is a specific condition which is called as lymphangioma of the alveolar ridge, which is found mainly in the neonates, which shows as a blue domed fluid filled lesions. So here in this picture you can see the lymphangioma of the alveolar ridge in the neonate. Histologic features: you can see multiple intertwining lymph vessels in a loose fibrovascular stroma. Cavernous hemangioma is made up of numerous dilated lymphatics which are lined by a single layer of endothelial cells with flattened plumped nuclei which contain lymph. So here you can see cavernous lymphangioma, in which these are the dilated lymphatics lined by endothelial cells. The nuclei of these cells is flattened. Now there is a specific thing called as papillary surface change. Those lymphatic vessels which are present just beneath the surface epithelium tend to fill or replace the connective tissue papilla, and this is called as papillary surface change. Occasionally, the lymphatic channels may be filled with blood, and this is called as hemangiolymphoma. And sometimes there is proliferation of the lymphatic channels with another connective tissue component, primarily the smooth muscles, and this is called as hemangiomyoma. Now the histological classification: first is the lymphangioma simplex, which includes capillary lymphangioma and lymphangioma circumscriptum, and it is composed of small thin walled lymphatics. Second is the cavernous lymphangioma, which is made up of dilated lymphatic vessels with surrounding adventitia. Third type is the cystic lymphangioma, which contains huge macroscopic lymphatic spaces surrounding by fibrovascular connective tissue. And the fourth type is the benign lymphangioendothelioma, in which the lymphatic channels dissect through the dense collagen bundles. Now, the treatment of the lesion is mostly surgical excision. Sclerosing agents may also be done, can also be used, and debulking of the tumor is indicated. Next lecture will be on myxoma. That's all for now. Happy studying.